Filipinos may need to tighten their belts in more ways than one this holiday season. That's as some Nochebuena items saw a 10% price increase based on the Trade Department's price monitoring data. The list includes Filipino Christmas dinner staples like ham, queso de bola, and elbow macaroni. Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual cites the rise in prices of raw materials, but he also assures Filipinos the agency is doing its best to limit price increases in basic goods.
I met with the food manufacturers a few weeks back, and I explained to them how I look at pricing. If a manufacturer produces a range of products that cater to various income classes of society, they can distribute the contributions to overhead and profit across, not uniformly in percentage terms, but so that the burden on the goods that are for the low-income families will bear a smaller part, and the goods, the premium brands for the same product line, you know, could carry heavier share of the burden for overhead and profit.
And before we go, a huge upset at the FIFA World Cup. Saudi Arabia stunned Lionel Messi's Argentina, beating the two-time winners 2-1. Argentina is ranked third in the world, while Saudi Arabia is way back at 51st. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. graces the celebration of the National Science and Technology Week, pushing for innovations as the world emerges from the pandemic. Our very own Pia Gutierrez now joins us with an update. Pia, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. assured Filipino scientists and researchers of the government's continued support for them as he again urged them to remain in the country and help establish a bigger pool of Filipino innovators. The president made a statement as he led the opening of the 2022 National Science and Technology Week here at the World Trade Center in Pasay City. In the speech, the president, who earlier admitted to being a frustrated scientist himself, lauded the skills and talents of Filipino scientists as he admired the new technologies presented by different agencies of the DOST at the exhibit here in the venue. He says the need to innovate has become more pronounced, especially as the country needs to survive in the future amid new challenges brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic, as well as the real threats posed by climate change. He added that hard science will continue to play a large part in coming up with these new solutions, and this just underscores the important role of scientists, researchers, and engineers. He also called on the Department of Science and Technology to invite local officials to come and see these available technologies, as they may be applicable in providing solutions to the different problems of local communities. The president added that as part of encouraging Filipinos, the government also plans to establish a scholarship program specifically for students of the STEM, or the science, technology, engineering, and mathematics strand, saying that this scholarship will not only be limited to educational opportunities here in the Philippines, but also in institutions abroad where these Filipino students may be accepted. Let's listen to President Marcos Jr.
We are facing a new world, very much a new world. COVID changed everything. And because it is a new world, these are new problems that we are facing. And therefore, we need to find new solutions. And innovation is the key. Innovation and agility. This celebration that we are doing of Science and Technology Week has taken on an added meaning, because the innovations that will come, that we will need, a large part of that will be from pure science and technology.
Meanwhile, Carmina, a series of activities have been lined up here at the World Trade Center for the celebration of the 2022 National Science and Technology Week. And this includes not only this exhibit here at the World Trade Center, but also a number of seminars and workshops designed to promote science and technology innovations here in the Philippines. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us live.